Larry Johnson's with me on the line today from Kennedy Ventures. Larry, good morning. Good to speak to you.
Yes, good morning. Good to speak to you as well.
You've had your final results plus an operational update out, Larry. Shares recently too returned from suspension after a delay in getting those accounts signed off. No doubt a frustration here for you, Larry, but a significant period nonetheless for the company.
No, you know, the frustration I know has been more on the investor side because myself, you know, I knew what was, you know, was happening and what had to happen. And, you know, as a CEO, you have to keep your eye on the target and not get sidetracked. So, you know, I try to never really get frustrated more than just push forward. You know, the delay in publishing obviously wasn't something that people wanted to see happen, especially myself. However, you know, as I've spoke many times, you know, I want to be able to have things correct and that, you know, what I say is what's being done at all times. So we had to go back through some significant information. And again, if you look at my background, you know, I come from the world of auditing. I've stayed many years being audited by KPMGs, the PwCs. And so the familiarity for me is always there. So I tend to, as I've talked to, you know, before, make sure that we cross all the T's and dot all the I's so that when things are posted, there's nothing missing. And again, unfortunately, this came right in the middle of the holiday season in Africa as well. And if you look at how Africa operates during the festive seasons, you know, they basically shut down almost the entire month of December and January. So that was all combined, which caused a delay, as well as, you know, taking the firm that was doing the auditing here in Africa, I had to take them down to the mine, you know, there was which needed to happen. So again, I apologize, obviously, for the delays, but the delay was necessary to be able to cross the T's and dot all the I's from the past.
Indeed, Larry, let's take a look now at what was achieved in the period. $3.25 million raised in two separate placings, plus, of course, you made your fourth shipment, too.
That's correct, which is very exciting. The fourth shipment has successfully gone. And, you know, and that's really in the first year. And as you know from the past, you know, the mine's been around for a very long time. And myself and the teams have successfully done four shipments within the first year. So I feel very, very good with that, very confident. And I'm looking to continue, you know, building upon that, obviously.
And so you're speaking to some new customers at the moment, are you?
Well, that's correct. You know, I'm always looking at the network that I've built over many years, and I'm still in good discussions with a second potential, and I've also started conversations with even a third. So I'm going to continue to keep that extension out there. We're going to be meeting again very soon, which I'll send some updates once, you know, I have more information on that. That's very exciting information to share.
Exciting indeed. What about as far as further exploration at the mines concerned? Larry, bring us up to date there.
Well, you know, first I'll go back just for a second on, you know, the shipments just for a second, because there's something very significant. As you've seen in many announcements, we continue to hit world-class grades. The last shipment was over 51%. There's nobody out there that will even come close to those numbers. So, again, that's a very exciting progress. It talks a lot about how the upgrades to the plant and things of that nature have allowed me to get to that place. And as far as exploration, that's going very, very well. We're, again, continuing the core drilling and working with, you know, two world-class firms, ALS, which is going to be actually doing the assaying, and MSA, which is a very prominent auditing firm that will be looking at the JORC signature. So that's going very, very well. And I brought on board some real focus into that effort, which I'll talk about more in, later on in some further announcements. But the exploration drilling is going very, very well.
And brought on board, Larry, some new people, a couple of new hires as well.
I did. You know, again, being, you know, 1 year under my belt, my focuses have been really to, you know, get the quality systems up and running, to obviously secure a world-class customer. Those things have been accomplished. And it allowed me to now take a further look in the depth of, you know, who's on board. So I've recently brought on board Mr. John Fay as the interim CFO. Very exciting. He's got over 40 years in finance. He was brought on board to assist me in pulling together all this information to report the results, as we've talked about today. And I've also, and this happened through my continued efforts working with universities. I have such a passion to work with students, last year students especially. And in doing that, you know, I met Mr. Ilunga, who is an actual lecturer at the University of Namibia and has, 17-plus years in mining. And I was able to meet him through his students. I brought on board two of his metallurgical students. And he's a lecturer of metallurgy, which, again, is such a key when it comes to the way the plant operates on a daily basis. Some people in manufacturing, which is the world I came from, would call him a process engineer. So he's got lots of experience. Working with his students, I was able to meet him. And we started a conversation, as I always do. And come to find out, you know, he came from the Congo, the DRC. And we actually worked and operated in the same area. So we had, you know, we laughed a lot on the various parts of the Congo. But we hit it off immediately. So I've now brought him on board. So he's, with me now, bringing things in a continued process improvement. When you start thinking about the name, and it honestly first got kicked off on, you know, one of my many trips into London, you know, people, when somebody new like myself comes on board, and I certainly have really tried to project the different strengths that I have brought to this company in a very short amount of time. You know, people, investors specifically, you know, would mention to me in the meetings, geez, what about changing the name? And so, you know, when you look at where we are today, we've come light years from where Kennedy started. And so we felt, you know, as a board that it was important to, let's refresh, you know, let's bring something really fresh, which includes the name change. And I'm excited about the name change. It wasn't done by me just sitting at my desk thinking up a name. You know, I involved the staff and my actual, you know, PA, who I have today, she picked the name. And so it was like a contest I put on, because I feel so strong always in engaging, you know, who you're working with. That way they feel such a part of the company, right? So I'm excited about the name change, and it's going to bring, I think, a freshness to the entire business.
When are you hoping to start trading under Cathera Global? Is it next month?
Yeah, it's looked to be, again, estimated to start next month. Obviously, there's going to be, further meetings coming up. I'll be coming into London in March, at the beginning of March, to have the yearly get-together. So we'll discuss that even further, but that's the estimated kickoff time, yes.
Well, it'll be good to see you in the studio. Hopefully we'll get the chance when you are here in London, Larry. Look, good to speak to you. Thanks very much.
Thank you, and I look forward to getting with you as well, and you have a great day, all right?